Good afternoon and welcome once again. I don't think you can all see me because of this screen, but I'm here. I'm here behind the screen, as it were. Happy Eastertide to everybody. Hope everybody's got some energy left after a busy Easter weekend. It's going to be great today to offer some of the music of Herbert Howells, one of my favorite composers. We've featured Howells' music at times during this series, but never had an entire concert devoted to his works, and so that's what we're going to be experiencing together this afternoon. Howells is one of the English pastoralists, as this group of composers is called. Vaughan Williams is perhaps the best known, and others such as Roger Quilter, we heard some songs of his just last week, actually, in Kathleen Radke's recital, and Stanford, Charles Wood to an extent, composers. They're called pastoralists, really, because when we listen to the music, it, for people who know and love England, it evokes those wide open spaces and those green colors and perhaps a distant spire or a historic cemetery or little dottings of sheep left and right, all of those things which make one smile and think of England. These composers write in that vein, and as so many composers do when they represent a culture or a country, their music sounds like what that country feels like. Howells is very much among them, although his influences are a bit more impressionistic and maybe a bit moodier, as one could say. I've written a short biography there of his. I was very fond of his church music growing up as a choir boy. I used to really look forward to singing his pieces, particularly the more dramatic ones. And I remember very excitedly telling my mother on one particular occasion that we were going to be singing the Collegium Regale Te Deum, and that she really must come to church and hear it. And her description of the music was, it sounded as though you were making it up as you were going along. So that was a bit underwhelming as a response, but it's funny, like some people who are quite knowledgeable about church music deeply love the music of Howells, and then others are left maybe just in this indifference. But I suppose there's that tension in all music that some people relate to it and some people don't relate to it as much until they've heard more of it, perhaps. So if you haven't related to Howells before, you've got about 40 minutes of music to figure out how to relate to it. So the pieces I've chosen are from a couple of collections, three collections, actually. In 1921, he published his first set of psalm preludes. They're all meditations on the verses of psalms. And so one of our selections is from that, a meditation on verse 4 of the Lord's My Shepherd, that particular psalm. And then the other is a meditation on verse 11 of Psalm 139, Domine Probasti. That psalm is one of my favorite psalms. And in this particular verse, the darkness is not darkness with thee. To thee, the darkness and the light are both alike. Beautiful sentiment. In the second set of psalm preludes, which he wrote in 1939, Howells selects that psalm verse. So both of those are in there. In 1918, he published three rhapsodies for the organ. There was eventually a fourth, but it came much later. And the third of these is the piece I'm beginning the program with. A rhapsody as a musical form is a somewhat improvisational exploration of harmonic shapes, colors, and rhythmic motifs. And this one is beautifully chromatic and beautifully ordered, and serene at times, but ecstatic as others. And it's real poetry in motion, beginning the recital with that one. And then the other three selections are from a 1940 publication. He was commissioned by Novello, the English publisher, to write six pieces for organists to play. And they're all very colorful in their own right. There are three from there, the Preludio Sine Nomine. Now, Sine Nomine is a hymn tune that we normally associate with the words, for all the saints. But there's no quotation of that hymn tune in this prelude. It's not heard, so I'm thinking, I've read quite a bit of scholarship on this music, and no one actually has explained the association of the title to the hymn tune. And since you can't hear it, I have to think that it was more a meditation on the saints and the holy city and their dwelling therein and their example thereupon and so forth than it is an actual quotation of the hymn. So more the sentiment than the tune. And then Master Tallis's Testament, one of Howells's most famous pieces for the organ, which is a variation on a theme of the Renaissance composer Thomas Tallis. So it combines Howells's late mid-20th century impressionism with the antiquity of Tallis. And then lastly, as it were, the title track for this concert, Saraband for the Morning of Easter, also from the Six Pieces for Organ. Saraband is a Spanish dance form that's normally associated with mourning, that is to say, mourning with a U, but this is a celebration of Easter mourning, that is to say, a mourning without a U, and a morning where the sun rises and the resurrection has occurred. And again, we hear in the piece a tension between the serenity of that moment and the ecstasy of what it represents more broadly. So the music of Howells this afternoon. Thank you for being with us. Next week, Andrew Ager returns to our series. Very excited about that. With soprano Irina Medvedeva, excellent local soprano, and they'll be singing some songs by Sergei Rachmaninoff. And 2 weeks hence, one of our tenors, Nicholas Savage, member of St. Andrew's Choir, will be presenting a recital which is a retrospective of 30 years of singing. I first met Nick when he was a choir boy at St. Matthew's Church nearly 30 years ago when I became organist there. And he's a great singer and has been a fantastic colleague from boyhood through adulthood. And so he is going to be celebrating his what he calls his 30th anniversary of singing in 2 weeks' time at our recital. And then we have a great lineup for May as well. And we'll be hearing about those things in the weeks to follow. Thank you for being here. And as always, the soup follows in the curry room and everyone is welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.